All right, we're here today with Matt Mastracci from DotSpots, and can you please introduce yourself, your company, and give a little overview of your application and your motivations for creating it?
Sure. So my name is Matt Mastracci. I'm a CTO of DotSpots. We founded DotSpots a couple of years ago as a way for people basically to annotate the news, give people a way to attach relevant material to articles that they might find on major news sites and major blogs. The idea is that we allow somebody to attach something, and then we use our engine to distribute what they attach on one story to semantically relevant areas on other news stories that would be appropriate for whatever they attach, whether it be media or their own comments, etc.
So you chose to use Wit to create this app. Can you tell us a little bit how you came to that technical decision?
Originally, before I worked on DotSpots, I was working on some prototypes of various applications, and I came across some information regarding GWT. I decided to give it a shot with one of my previous projects, and that previous project, actually, it didn't take me very long to develop. I basically managed to go from a prototype to implementation of that previous product very quickly. So when we started DotSpots, I decided that I'd give GWT another try. We started from the beginning, from a fresh code base. When we originally started DotSpots, we wanted the experience for the user to be very, very seamless. So when the user visits our website and they click around between the various sections, we didn't want to have them wait for page loads all the time. We want them to be able to click around very quickly, get the information they want as quickly as possible without having to worry about page load times, etc. Additionally, at DotSpots, we actually provide the users a Firefox extension. And because we use GWT, we can use the same code on our website that we do in our Firefox extension. And all we need to do is just a simple recompile.
Can you tell us a little bit about the scalability of your code?
Our code is scaled very well from the beginning. Right now we have at least 40 or 50,000 lines of client source, and we found that our development ability hasn't really changed that much. We were using Eclipse to develop our GWT code, and we still use the same refactoring tools, the same same code navigation tools that we did when our source code was tens of thousands and even less than 10,000 lines of code. So we found that as our code scales, we don't find that we'd run into the traditional problems that a normal Web 2.0 company might, where you end up with such a large amount of JavaScript that when you try to make a change, there's just so much code that you have to spend so much time changing that it just becomes an unmanageable mess. So we tend to do a lot of refactoring still, and that being able to do that with such a large and mature code base has definitely been a big advantage for us.
Well, what new features would you like to see in GWT? What are you most excited about?
Some of the 2.0 features that we've seen in GWT that we're really excited about, the out-of-process hosted mode is going to be very important for us. We right now, because we have a non-traditional GWT app with a Firefox extension, we tend to have to wait for about 3 to 4 minutes while our compile finishes and the code is linked, and before we can restart a Firefox browser to see our code in action. But now that we have access to out-of-process hosted mode, we should be able to simplify that by allowing our developers to start up the browser with the out-of-process hosted mode plugin and immediately see their changes reflected instead of having to go through the cycle again and again. As well, the story of your compile code that we've seen coming up seems really interesting for us. Basically, we spend a lot of time trying to figure out exactly how we can make our Firefox extension as small as possible, and we've been doing a lot of that by hand. But now that we should have access to a more detailed description of how our code was compiled, we can then shrink the size of our extension with significantly less effort.
So it sounds like you're pretty excited about Gwt. What would you say still needs to be improved?
Some of the issues we've been having with Gwt, because we run as a Firefox extension, when a user doesn't update their extension, but we update our server code, we tend to run into incompatible remote service exceptions. So we have some workarounds for that, and we tend to have to force the user to upgrade their extension more often. But in cases where the client and server code may not necessarily be 100% in sync, Gwt could certainly, there could be some changes made to some of the RPC code to make it easier for us to deploy these things at different times and have an up and down level compatibility story. As well, some of the work that we've been doing in the extension requires us to add in our own multiple document support for widgets. Currently, the Gwt code, of course, assumes that you have a single document. A testament to the architecture of Gwt, it didn't take us that much time. What we've done is we've actually added our own versions of the widgets, which are just subclasses, which support creation in another document. And that basically allowed us to use more than one document in our Gwt app.
So to wrap this up, how would you compare your experience with Gwt to your experiences in using other Ajax toolkits?
I've used a number of Ajax toolkits over the years, and Gwt is actually a different beast. When you work with the other Ajax toolkits, you have to think separately about your server code, which is generating static HTML, and your client code, which is augmenting it. With Gwt, what you do is you build a product. You don't really have to think about this arbitrary split between server rendering and client rendering. You're just always building. You're building one unified product, and because we just build a single product, we just go ahead and build it. We don't have to worry about whether something is going to be rendered on the server, something is going to be rendered on the client. We don't have to worry about keeping stuff in sync between the two because both the client and the server are sharing the same code, and we basically just run our compile process and it just works. So it saved us a lot of effort.
All right, Matt, thank you very much.
Great, thanks a lot.